Welcome back, everybody, here to your last game of the night coming out here from the joinDOTA Red Stream. We are here for the Bigpoint Battle. Fnatic EU going up against Lions Pride here in our quarterfinal matchup. How will we advance through to see who goes to go up against Team Empire in the semifinals? Well, let's find out together. Lions Pride's going to be over on the Dire side for this best of one matchup. Fnatic over on the Radiant side. And join me on my side is my Capitalist. What's up?
Not much. Just preparing myself.
We don't know what we're going to get, man. We never know what we're going to get. We could have ourselves an 80-minute farm game. We could have ourselves a 10-minute GG. We could have ourselves a 40-minute bloodbath. And we could have a combination of all of those.
Yeah, like Fnatic is always a team that brings their own style and their own flavor into the game. And Lions Pride is also a newer team, but we've also thrown the twist of three different stand-ins. Like, one or two stand-ins, you still draft normal.
Yeah.
And you just go, okay, what is your role? Presumably, if you're a 4 or 5, you can play any support hero, so you're good. You just draft normal. Three different stand-ins? I don't know. I don't know, man. We'll have to see if they do something.
You might notice a couple of the stand-ins, too. Like, Coco's been around for a while. He's actually an old teammate of Mini. Blackout also has been hovering around the scene for a very, very long time. And then Mork, who's... I don't know if that's exactly how you're supposed to say his name, or Mook. Either way, he played for Natolic IU. The team I remember him playing for. Was it Natolic SA? Actually, no, it was Natolic SA. That's Natolic SA. I was one of the Natolic squads. That was what he used to play for. The Minions assembled them all together to play up here. They wouldn't have gotten this far if they were noobs. So we'll see how they go up against Fnatic. And Fnatic had gone with a drop, which looks very, very familiar. Correct me if I'm wrong. The only thing they won't have is going to be the Batrider. The Batrider was allowed to come through for them last time. And that gave them their offlaner for Trixie. So they won't have that option this time around. If you also look through the Lions Pride banning stage, I take out the Lifestealer and the Darkseer. I don't know if you managed to jump into the Dota TV that was being played out for the last game. But they were up against Darkseer, and he caused them a lot of issues. So they're removing the possibilities for a horrendous team fight. And they're getting the heroes that they know they're comfortable with. So the Gyro, the Visage, two heroes actually played in their last game as well, so they'll give those two guys a whirl.
Yeah, and then also Fnatic. I think this is going to become more and more standard when an Alchemist is picked up so early. Banning away the Dragonite. Taking away the Dragonite, they just really flow. They have the same strengths and some of the same weaknesses. It's just that overwhelming strength that they bring to the table of being able to force a lot of team fights early on. They're super tanky. They just dominate the mid game and still are able to transition into late game fairly well. And they're also good laners. Like, it's not like they are terrible laners and make up for in the mid game at all. They're very, very strong. So I think that's going to become more and more standard. And then also Furion being taken away by Lions Pride. So smart ban so far, and we're just waiting on Fnatic's third pickup.
Yeah, that we are, man. Take away the split pushes, take away the team, the towered killers, aka poison dragons, and then Lone Druid and Trio Protector. It just makes it so simple again in the draft. Like, the bans you can look at and say, yeah, okay, we could really be looking at some strong push, or be looking at this different scenario, but either way you look at it, it's still, like, mini. Doesn't matter about his standings. The way he does his draft is always very, very, I don't want to say standard, but structured. We've actually found this structure in the European scene that just doesn't get messed around with that much. Like right now you see from Fnatic, like they just picked up a VS. And most of the time you go, ooh, VS, different hero, whoa. But it's still very factually sound. You're going to get this aura stack up now with a Chem, which instantly makes me think of Luna for Era. Even though we've got the Alchemist, we know Hani will want to take that in towards the middle lane. So you've got such a strong pushing lineup if they're going to combine up all three of those auras together to a point that Visage, Puck, and Gyro won't have any way of dealing with this early game push. And Puck, I suppose, got a little bit of orb so he can do some fun stuff. And then Maybe there is no fun stuff. OD will be the pickup here from Fnatic instead. And that throws my theory out the window, man. That makes it for a farming up Alchemist. We still got a lot of power behind it. But the only aura stacks are going to be coming from Chen as well as the VS. Unless we get Trixie now fighting its way to play a Beastmaster on the long lane.
And dude, it's funny because that also throws my theory out the window is maybe we would see a Beastmaster offlane. Just because the Vengeful Spirit and the Beastmaster auras combined, very potent combo. You also add a lot more pushing power to the Chen you already have picked up, and also a lot more late game power to the Alchemist, who is going to be hitting so fast and so hard with both of those auras. But with the OD, I mean, it's still possible, but I think that if they were going to go that route, they needed a really heavy mid-game controller, and Puck was already picked up by Lion's Pride. So I think we're going to have a little bit more standard, a little bit safer Suicide Lane. Beastmaster Suicide Lane is easily shut down. You really have to be proactive in protecting your Ancient's pull, and then also be really good at blocking the creep wave that you can pull it back. Lion's Pride, though, they're going to go for one of those Suicide Lane heroes that we have been seeing more and more often.
That's
going to be the Lich.
That's a mid lane, man. That's a mid lane. They're going to throw Puck to the off lane. Minnie's done this before. It's Lich up against the OD. This is their way of dealing with the OD. So you run Lich for the solo mid. You'll throw Gyro on what should be a safe lane with the Visage. And probably just to balance out the possibility of not getting a lot of farm, they're going to grab an Enigma. Or an Enchantress of their own. So they got some kind of jungling-style hero. And that'll put Alchemist free-farming on the bottom lane. Puck will try and stay as close as he possibly can to that. The other option is they get a Keeper of the Light and they go Coddle, Visage, and Gyro all down to the bottom lane. So at least they try and contest that and leave Puck up on the top. That'll be my switch around here for Lion's Pride if they're going to do it.
Yeah, I would personally rather see the aggressive trial lane just because giving a Lich farm, like, that's okay, and obviously it's the big problem of OD and how to deal with that. But you're gimping the Puck and you're giving Lich farm, which isn't terrible to give Lich farm by any means. I mean, his ultimate is very, very powerful, but he's sort of a, you know, one-shot hero. And going into those team fights, if he doesn't hit a good ultimate, then all that farm that's on him, maybe he picks up an early Aghanim's or something. He doesn't hit that, then all of that farm goes to nothing, and then you've got a gimped Puck. So I would really like to see an aggressive trial lane here. They've already got a good setup for it. Gyrocopter Visage is good combo. Like you said, Keeper of Light would be a nice control in that lane where it'd be able to provide a lot of burst damage to help with the Visage Soul Assumptions. Or maybe some excess control, something like a Rubick or something wouldn't be that bad. You've got a couple of different abilities that would be nice to be able to steal. So either some control or the Keeper of the Light would be a good aggressive tri-lane combo. And as long as they don't lose their aggro tri, they're looking really strong. Lich versus the OD, Puck in the safe lane versus whoever Fnatic picks up right now. I think their lane should go really well as long as they don't lose the aggressive tri.
I still want to see if they can get it, man. These guys are taking way too long to pick. the bans were standard for them. They're both worried about what's going to be played on an offlaner. I'm assuming with a Lich in the solo mid, because I've seen mini draft for it before. I'd like to be proved right.
Alright, I think it's something that you said. I thought you said they were old teammates of Mini, but Mini said, tell Toby that I kick his ass. I was the one who had to connect those guys because Link and Crit are on vacation, plus Coco equals Ryze.
Ah, oh, damn you, Ryze.
Oh, okay, all right.
Okay.
I gotcha.
I was sure they were old teammates. I was sure they're old teammates. So thank you very much, Minnie. Thank you very much for the updates. You could try and kick
Brennan
my
kick your ass.
he could try and kick my ass the next lad of event, but you know it's not easy. And Doombringer, the last one to be picked up here. We saw him feature multiple times over the last couple of weeks, in fact. Even more over the last 2 days. An insanely strong farmer, insanely hard person to lane against as well. This could almost push us into something which, just if Fnatic want to screw with them, they can run Harney Doom in that middle lane. And then you can put the OD, VS, Even with the OD on a safe lane bottom and run the Chen VS into the Lion's Pride jungle with the Alchemist up there as well. I would love to see them screw around with that. And there goes my theory out the window. It's going to be a Templar Assassin for Lion's Pride. So, Mini is supporting Lich. And, yeah, theory throwing. But TA versus Hani, this is not going to go well, man. This is not going to go well. Ryze is Templar Assassin. Wait, it's Ryze? I suppose with all the support ends that he will be taking up the mid-solo role. But TA is not a fun hero against an OD. You'd be so low on mana, you can't even cast a refraction. Let alone a meld and a refraction. You'll never get a combo to happen. And then you've got the possibility of Doom shutting down. Well, he could shut down anybody. He can also control the puck. The Doom ulti, which will also go through a BKB of Hester Joe. So he won't, no matter what he does, he won't be at a flat cannon during a team fight if Doom sets his eyes on him. This is just a... Yeah. I'm loving this pickup, man. I'm loving Doom, and I'm loving the fact that he really is back. Nothing really much got changed to him. Like, he got changed a couple of patches ago, correct me if I'm wrong. It was just his Devour. And I think also the extra effect of Scorched Earth. He gets a little bit more regeneration from that now.
Yeah, it was some minor buffs. Did make him a little bit stronger, but... and then the other one was the Aghanim's, the most recent change. But honestly, that isn't what... brought him into the scene.
No one who has picked the Doombringer in the last 2 weeks in a competitive game has bought an Aghanim Scepter.
No.
Even when they've got the money to do so, they will still pick something else. Like a Shiva's Guard over it.
Yeah, extremely situational. It would have to be late game, it would have to be going up against a melee hero, something like Nakes or something that Doom is really, really powerful versus, disabling some of those passive abilities, and then just being able to also have that melee hero being constant range. Even if it's just another 10 seconds, that's another 10 seconds that Lifestealer is completely out of the team fight. And it's just such a situational, like, it's an interesting idea, but it's so extremely situational that nobody's really thinking about picking it up. Trixie is going to focus. I'm wondering if he's going to go try and go into the enemy jungle. Yeah. Because the fact that I was going to talk about this, the Doom jungle isn't the fastest in the world. You kind of rely on being able to stack. The fastest way is to steal a tornado creep, eat a tornado creep, stack up a hard camp, and then pop a clarity, get yourself to 200 mana, and pop a 4 stack. And that's pretty much the fastest way you can do it with Doom. Here, you've got a Chen sharing the jungle with you. It's going to make for a very crowded space. Doom can farm the two easy camp and the hard camp on the side, and then No-Tail's just going to have to focus on the other three camps if they insist on sharing the same jungle.
Once they see that both Mini and Blackout in the bottom lane, he'll head up north. All he's looking for was a good creep, and he finds a Thunderclap creep, which is not what he wanted. There's too much mana for very little game. Mini now being stunned up, and that's first blood already. Flag starts off with the magic missile. They couldn't decide which one was the real one, and Hero almost got a full concoction channel up just then before he threw that one out. Very simple kill on a Lich. And he is just meant to be babysitting and sitting back. Puck was the one who can evade this Alchemist. That's why I thought the Puck would be the one on that bottom lane. They put the Lich in the middle lane up against Hani. That was just a better matchup.
Yeah. This is something where Puck offlane, he isn't a very strong offlaner. Like, he's got an escape mechanism, but it's very, very... you can't really rely on it very well. And... so they need something like a Lich to be able to bring the lane back. With the Lich coming into the scene more and more, you're seeing some of those more interesting, a little bit more classic offlaners. I mean, Puck used to be a little bit more popular as an offlaner. Heroes like Morana have also been being seen left and right. And it's mainly because Lich is able to bring that lane back for them. They don't have to be so far forward. And as you said, TA just getting rocked in middle.
Yeah, it's not going to be a fun place to be, man. Hester Joe is down to 195 mana. The bottle's going to arrive for him at least, but he knows that this is just the start of things to come. And it looks like bottom lane things are not going to be as easy for Mini again. Magic Missile will fly, and Lich is dead for a secondary time. And Fly even had a blockout, blackout. He's got himself an orb in 2 seconds time, and then Concoction's got to get that stun. They could dive it. He can at least throw the Concoction. I didn't think that would do that much damage. 18 life points he goes down to.
Yeah, if he'd held on to another half second, he would have actually picked up the kill.
But if he held on for another half second, it probably would have been hitting himself because he would have been out of range.
Yeah. This is Doom is gonna have a really hard time at top though. This is one of the bad things. Offlane Doom is not very strong. It just a dual lane is able to kick him out because Visage with that Grave Chill allows him to get off a lot of auto attacks. And Doom, everybody knows, Doom has no armor.
Yeah.
So he's feeling the full brunt.
Mini. Fly just says hi. Surprise, bolt sex. And that's now the third death for the Lich in the bottom lane. Because Fly took the 2-minute invis. Or the rune that spawned for 2 minutes. Trixie will go down the top lane as well. So at least there's a little bit of revenge kill here. Ryze able to get that kill as the gyro. And then at least gets himself a little bit of health. Up to level 4. So the gyro is looking good as far as a kill goes. 13 for nil, not too shabby. But that is 18 for 12 in the middle lane. And this is just a... yeah. Good luck to Hester Joe, man. Good luck to Hester Joe. He's getting so minimal experience. It's level 5 up against a level 3 3/4.
I think the thought process was here that TA has enough a high enough mana pool that he won't go below 100. So if he's allowed to constantly bottle crow, then he'll always be able to have the mana to pop a refraction. But it still doesn't take away the fact that you're still getting a bunch of damage on OD, and he's able to deny every single creep. And even some of the creeps he doesn't deny, you're trapped inside that imprisonment for it. So even though it might defensively be able to deal with some of the harassment of an OD, it's still not going to stop all of the monster CS that he's going to get and denying all that experience from you.
Oh, yeah. I will at least give Lion's Pride one big prop. It's Fluffy the Devourer of Weeds! The courier.
Yeah.
It's nice. As opposed to the flying, like, I don't even know what
Captain
to call
Bambo.
That. Is that who it is?
That's what people have been calling it. I like it.
Skypender. I'm gonna call it Skypender. It's like Skypender. Look at him. He's just, it's like little wings on him. He's like a cute flying bison. Flying bisons are actually quite cute as well. At least the one from Avatar was. Appa. Appa. I want to call him Appa. His name is Appa. Yip, yip. Mini. They're going to try on Trixie. If bottom lane didn't work, he's going to hope for something better up on top lane. A Grave Chill into a Frost. Trixie. Well, he can at least set up one quick clap before he dies. But there's more support coming in. Notel's got himself a nice nuke, which is just begging for a Visage. Or possibly Mini again. Halaterra, VS done, and the nuke from Notel. Well, he already knows one's going to go down. Yes, it's going to be a kill. Poor Vinny. Notel will take his life. Ira throws the concoction, finds Ryze a little bit too far out. Notel still on the tail. Medallion of Courage, that one attack is going to be enough. Double kill for Notel. We kind of missed, like, remember those old matchup things we had in Warcraft 3? This person killed this person however many times. Like, we have to rely on memory in this. I prefer to have that stat back again.
Yeah, there are a lot of classic Dota 1 stats that just aren't seen. I would like to be able to. I mean, you remember, like, the game ended, and all of a sudden there was this wealth of information that just came at you.
Yep.
Everything from wards being bought and all that sort of thing.
It was always available for our spectators. Us spectators would sit there and flash it up. It was the reason why we would always miss so many kills. And it was the classic saying of, you bring up the stat screen, someone's gonna die. So when you had a really boring game, you just bring up the stat screen because you're like, someone's gonna die now, because it covered your entire screen. it was transparent and you could barely see the mini map, but you're like, okay, I think I can work this one out. Someone's gonna come down. It's like, okay, while you're trying to go through stats? Yeah, it's Hawk, hold in position. I want to call him Mihawk, but I know it's not Mihawk.
Yeah.
Let's call him Visage. An Alchemist wants to take the damage. Likes it like that.
I think this dual lane is just completely unafraid of the tri-lane.
Oh, yeah.
Like, Notail's picked up a lot of experience. He's gotten a couple of kills as well, so he has just really boosted his levels.
He's walking around with a hand of God. And a troll and a Wilkin to support him, so they've already got the armor. And he knows he's got Ira just around the corner as well. So Ira is already ready to fight him, like straight away. If he can find a kill, he'll take it. Nothing can stop him too. If they want to dive this, even with the three players here, like you find Mini down in the in that little spot. So he's down there in the sidebob Matt hiding spot. There goes the troll. So they can't easily get the kill, but they're not fearful of diving it. I'm pretty sure Notel just wants a different creep. Because he could take a third one. And what's he gonna get?
Middle.
Oh, he's too close. What's Hani? how much mana did TA have? How much mana did TA have at the end of that match?
I think he had like 80 or something.
Okay, so he was basically maxed, imprisoned. And now bottom lane, also Puck falls off the lane by the Doom. Bottom tower is under attack. Sorry, back to what you're saying.
Not gonna get the kill though. Oh, just, you remember when I said he wasn't going to go below 100 mana? Well, that's early on. Once you start getting those fast levels, top era might go down.
Yep. There's a lot of damage on him. Hand of God keeps him alive just a little bit longer. But only a little bit. And Notel starts running away. Yeah. But once you get that full level of Astral Imprisonment, bringing a TA down to 70 mana is actually not that difficult. Notel's going to take a little bit of damage right now. The Familiars don't have themselves a Stomp, hence they're not looking for that. And Hester Joe's already welcomed back to mid lane. He's got 170 mana after two imprisonments. And this will now be the third. 39. He has 39 mana points. I'm wondering if he can actually go lower than that. Hey, Hester Joe, just run back in there again. Let Hani imprison you again. I'd like to see the effect of four imprisonments on Hester Joe. It should be about 20 or 30, shouldn't it? Here's Honey again. Like he's trying to give it a shot. Damn it, Hester Joe. For the purposes of science, walk closer. At least he finds himself a region.
He likes being a guinea pig of science.
Donate your body for something, man.
Well, I don't know. He's going to rotate out. He knows he can't sit in that lane any longer, so maybe they can pick up some sort of kill at bottom.
Well, the TA trap is going to slow down Fly. Meld hit already, and Puck going to throw the ult. They will be able to get this kill. But Hester Joe also going to cop a concoction to the face, and Trixie would like to chase this one down, but he doesn't have mana to throw out his Doom or anything more. In the meantime, Lion's Pride are looking to push in that top lane a little bit more while Hani continues to free farm and build himself up a 4-star. Which, by the way, he has in about 200 gold.
And he's just getting so huge. And he doesn't even have to pick up an early mech, which you normally see because Notel has picked up a ton of farm. He's obviously going to be picking that up. In fact, he has the gold for it right now.
Mm-hmm. And in fact, buys it now. Courier will transfer it out, and Hani goes back to his game. Hester Joe, for the purposes of science, goes down to 351. He's got boots and a wand and a DD room bolted up. Summary of what he owns. And this observer of the Radiant side perfectly saw Lion's Pride's rotation. So Hani has no fear of coming out and doing these little imprisonments. And he keeps using his Tranquil Boots. Surprising too, he didn't pick up just the buckler. Like, it's worthwhile just having a buckler, because then you can at least trigger off your aura. Notel, trouble for him. There's gonna be a lot of trouble, in fact. He's gonna pop this Hand of God right now if he wants to live. Imprisonment, able to hold away and then Fly. Swaps in Mini. The Centaurs and Familiar is going to get some good stomps off here. Or at least the Familiar is itself a good stomp. Managed to catch the entire Fnatic lineup in that middle lane. The fantastic Astral Imprisonment, and better swap to make sure they got another kill for it.
Air's just manfighting. Oh, he actually put himself in a bad position here with the teleport from Mini.
They're going to give it a shot. Air's going to TP out. There's no stun to stop him.
Chained Frost. Mini's just so underfarmed. 052.
Are you saying that just to pray that Mini gets all his level 6 so he does actually have a Chain Frost?
Uh-huh. Because then he actually has an impact in teamfights and not just denying waves.
He's got his frost, man. He possibly could get a point up in armor as well. Be nice for his team, but level 1 armor buff. I suppose the movement slow and the attack slow is still going to remain. But the bonus armor of 3. Doombringer would like that one. What's Doom sitting on? One level of armor. One point of armor, sorry. Running a hand of Midas with a devouring Doom. Net worth of 3.5k. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all.
Nope.
Especially and considering he's made. Just realized too, Trixie, no matter how this goes down, he still managed to die two times. No, I'm not entirely sure how. Blackout now been imprisoned up twice. Harney's got three extra sets of mana of intelligence. He's going to look for these, orb damage. And these familiars just drop. It's almost as effective as seeing a flat cannon up on a gyro during a team fight. Basically doesn't allow familiars to be anywhere. And now they've got initiation. OD ulti disintegrates the visage. And then goes through the puck as well. And maybe has to joke and bring down this mid tower. But there's TP's already coming back. OD very quickly imprisons up on the TA. He got the trap off. So at least slowed down Harney, but Hester wants to keep following. He's got a lot of movement speed with this haste rune. He knows he can keep chasing down Harney. Harney, 1 second away from another imprisonment. And now the No-Tail's here. Four staff up. Imprisoned. He's like, No-Tail, do your duty, ma'am. Nuke him down and be the sacrificial lamb. Ho ho! So, Doom, level death,
boom.
Orb, Chen didn't even throw the nuke, Era through the concoction though. I wouldn't have been surprised if Chen actually cast the nuke and had never actually connected because he was dead too fast.
Yep.
The funny thing is though,
this game, look
at the net worth. Rises the hope, sitting at 4.9k net worth, and now he's gone. Call down, Harney's moving in, and I don't know if Ryze saw that one, but he tried to go down and evade Harney, and he just lost the net worth battle.
I guess there goes their hope, huh?
I don't want to say that, man. I don't want to say that. Pandora is definitely holding her box very tightly sealed.
Oh, I'm being depressing today. That's what.
Are you? Really? I never would have noticed, man. Esther Joe.
You notice this build from Fly, by the way?
I might notice Harney killing off everybody. And in comes your concoction stun. They're looking over at Mini. They're just focusing Mini. He's dead before the Alder can even try it. But at the same time, Chen, Dominator's Brig, finally ended by Puck. But the rest of Fnatic, they're moving back to the Chen army. And they just got an imprisonment out. Puck is not having a great time here. Now 209 mana, I'm hearing a concoction fly, and it goes over towards Ryze, who also gets himself caught inside. Bit of a toxic spray, but Trixie caught more. Whoops! Had the crash from the Alchemist. Never a great thing when Era's running away, but mid-swap. Look at their soul assumption go too.
Yeah. It's not gonna kill him, but it'll put him down pretty low.
Actually, are you sure? That looks like a full channel. Actually, no, they're missing one point. It's not a max soul assumption. What level is that? It's level 3. That actually might be enough to kill off Trixie.
No. Not with magic armor.
Oh, that's true, because we're still going to take into account too, the toughness aura still here. But he's got the negative 3 on him. Like, he's still got the effect of the Medallion of Courage on him.
But it's a visage nuke.
Oh, yeah, too, so it doesn't even matter. Yeah, okay. He gets stunned by
the orb.
The orb and the right click. It actually wasn't even. Okay, there goes Fly. Double kill for Visage. I was told last night I pronounced his name incorrectly multiple times. And I'm like, man, Visage sounds more like a man as opposed to Visage.
In Dota 1, it's a cool name. Like, Visage is an actual word, but I like as a name, I always say Visage. That sounds legit.
Yeah. What does actually Visage mean? I don't know. Harney, whoop. Imprisonment. Elias probably really thinking about pushing this because if they do, they're going to be dead very, very quickly. Concoction flies. OD throw the ulti. Yeah, he does. Burns up the Visage as well as Mini. He's so low on life, and Mini got the ulti off and is actually going to get a kill on a no-tail. Down goes the Chen. It's a full 10 bounce ulti. Trixie, he's got this Ulman. Run, Mini. Run. He'll be fine. Ryze will not. Trixie even gonna doom it. That's not really needed. That's overkill. And it looks like Mini even helps to kill off somebody else who was rolling around. Puck helped kill off the OD.
Mm-hmm. He was chasing down, Mini was able to pick up that kill. So it was actually a decent trade for them, considering the fact that they are behind. That was actually perfect. Part of that was Minnie's bounces on Chain Frost, bouncing all over Chen. It used to be that Chen was sort of like, sort of a pseudo counter just because you were bringing so many units into the field. You know, it's like, well, RNG, you're just going to bounce a lot of your damage. But with 10 bounces, just, you're eventually, no matter how many units there are, you're still going to be able to hit the heroes a couple times. And, No-Tail paid the price for that one.
I have a definition for you. It's visage is a it's a person's face. It is a noun. It's a person's face with reference to the form or proportions of the features. An elegant, angular visage.
You know, Toby, I could have told you that, but I didn't really want to make a dictionary time.
And I'm making a dictionary time. And visage. In fact, right. Here you go.
Visage.
There you go. Visage. Yeah, I don't know if you could.
Did you just put it up on screen? Is that what you just did?
No. I have the thing where the guy pronounces it, and I played it. So it's like, it's visage. And I'm like, yeah, man. Like, talking about people's names though. People's names could be different. Like sometimes it's Toby, sometimes it's Tobias. In this case, it's just Toby. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Well, what I wanted to talk about, what I was going to use that whole lack of action going on where both teams were going to separate was Vengeful Spirit's skill build. He went with a 1-4-1 build. So that means leaving Magic Missile at level 1, going Max Wave of Terror, and then after that, his secondary is going to be Vengeance Aura. This is a old school Han build, actually. When they moved Vengeful Spirit over into Han, they actually made it so her stun was the same duration at all levels. And because of that, people figured out that there was a lot more damage coming out from the armor reduction and the Vengeance Aura than just the extra nuking damage from Magic Missile. You could output a lot more damage even early on. We saw this a little bit in Dota 1, but it was really, really rare. It's mainly because of Han, and that's where Fnatic obviously had a great amount of success.
Well, trouble. Nice imprisonment. Able to evade the visage.
Uh-oh.
That flies in a lot of trouble. He goes silence the second he came out there, so he was unable to swap himself out, even using the soul assumption to help kill off centaurs. And No-Tail just starts sending his centaurs back to base. But all of Lion's Pride have grouped up here in the middle lane, and Harney starts his imprisonment battle again. The funny thing is, though, like, you look at this game, and it's only 5,000 golden experience advantage the way of Fnatic. Like, I know we're kind of be like joking around with how much Fnatic have been dominating everything, but over these last fights, Lion's Pride have been starting to drag themselves back in here again. Harney, though, is still very, very powerful, especially when he does this kind of thing. Like, Ryze getting doomed up as well, and then Harney drops the ulti. Mini almost pops from just that. Doom will actually work to kill off the Gyro, while the Lich ulti again gets a full 10 bounces off.
Yeah, earlier in that team fight, Visage actually had the familiar stunts was actually really well done. You saw that army of centaurs coming forward. That could have been an easy escape. But he had that, the familiar stun came down, stopping the centaurs from being able to hit their stuns. Really well done. This Visage has actually played a really good game. He's going to be able to pick up mech soon on top of the Medallion of Courage he already has. He hasn't died much, so he actually has a decent bit of farm. The biggest problem is that even though it is only a 5,000, now looking about a 6,000 lead, biggest problem is that their main cores don't have any items. TA obviously has absolutely nothing. Their big carry, Gyrocopter, he doesn't have anything at all. He's still working towards his BKB, hasn't picked it up just yet. He actually was originally going for a Helm of Dominator, but I think he just got dominated on a little bit too much and felt that he needed teamfight right away. So, unfortunately, he would have BKB, but he has this sort of split item build right now. Radiant's top tower is
under attack. Fly's gotta be ready for this, man. Everyone's coming middle lane for Lion's Pride. Five-man Dotas! Stalin already starts off there on the Templar Assassin. Urn charge as well being thrown out, and Harney found himself and bagged himself a little fishy there. Era once more though. Centaur stuns and then the OD orbs, they keep the puck controlled. Era was unable to get that concoction up, but Trixie seems to just walk into the middle of the entire Lion's Pride lineup, and that level death going to work. A level 9 hero from the level death, which has the multiplier of 3, so he got the bonus on it. And now they will take the tier 2 tower for taking two of the heroes as well.
Yeah. This is, they're just going to be able to take the rest of the tier 2s. Take the rest of the tier 2s. They could probably crack open base if they really want to, but they have a lot of room for growth. Like, OD can obviously hit much, much harder once he has a Scythe of Ice. You can even pick up Ashivas, things like that. And Alchemist, he doesn't have his AC yet. Like, they have a lot of room for growth for cracking open the base, and that just isn't the same. Like, Gyrocopter is a hero who plays... He doesn't play very well from behind. He wants to be able to have... He wants to have a significant gold advantage, and he's able to be sort of a hard carry because of the fact he abuses Flat Cannon and the massive amount of farm that he has in the game. But this game, he's playing very much far from behind. He could pick up his BKB and just another 10 gold. But that's honestly going to be a minimal amount. Like you said in the beginning of the game, Doom's going to be able to lock him down really easily, and that's going to keep away that Flat Cannon hits and the also the cooldown, which is really important in the team fights. Mm-hmm. So it's looking very, very grim. But Lion's Pride, there's always the potential just to be able to get a couple of pickoffs and start snowballing.
Oh,
that's
Trixie.
Their biggest hope.
Yeah, the Centaur Stompies cast the Doom, and Puck will go down. He knew he had enough to do it, and then able to Shadow Blade to evade the meld hit of Templar Assassin. Follow the flames, TA. Follow the flames if you want the kill, but don't follow the flames, actually. Because Honey is just around the corner. He's almost hoping that Trixie will be able to pop an ability just to try and trigger that Essence Aura. They could both get a Mech Charge and Arcane Boost. That'll work as well. And Tornado starts up as well. So this will be the Tier 1 tower. Vias already swapping back in his Joe. Lucholti on the way in. Hits on Fly. He's going to bail out of here. OD Ulti takes out Hester Joe. And then four-staffed into Mini as well.
Uh-oh.
Very quick to move. And the Centaur prepares itself for the Visage. Four heroes on the sidelines. And at the same time, I think Era, was he just managed to get a snipe back kill on the bottom?
Yeah. He killed the Gyrocopter. No problem. No problem. So... lose a team fight at top, lose a tower at top, lose a pickoff at bottom. Lion's Pride. They had to win their lanes early, and their hope, I think, was ganking like the OD. Like the TA just getting shut down so hard. It's a really bad problem. Like TA needs some early farm, that way she can start moving around and killing heroes, and she still does not have anything. She's working towards a BKB, but
It's not going to complete that before the tier 3 tower is going to be brought down. It's a long way to go. Whoop, Fly. Are you looking for a... I think he's looking to exploit the bug there. Where you're able to swap with someone and send them straight back. Puck's already gone down after he tried to initiate in. And Templar Assassin walks in. The Doom's over on Mini. He'll die from that Doom. He'll die from that Doom effect. The rest of them have started to rotate back down. Holy crap. Okay, he won't die from the Doom effect, he'll die from OD, just attacking him. And the BKB goes off from the Gyro, and that actually stops all the extra damage that Hani can deal. No tell, just pops the mech, allows him to survive a little bit longer, and Era comes back in, and then just fists down the Gyro. While OD is sent back to base, and Era stuns himself up, and look back over the Tier 3 tower. VS, there's a swap, pulling Visage back in, and GG is the call from Mini. And all the boys say, thank you very much for the care you've taken. It's going to be GG. And they will bring down the mid-racks. And also, because of the 10-second tick down, we'll get our official GG straight out.
Wait, what? What were they talking about? I missed it.
Yeah, Mini didn't realize that if you type GG, it brings up the... He must have read the changelog. Because it only happens in private games. It doesn't happen in the public game. So if you type GG in a public game, you wouldn't expect to see it. But if you type GG, then it will give you it. Which I think is actually a little bit more interesting when you have both teams typing in GG, and then the team which is winning will also have the same thing pop up, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
Which will make for an interesting thing.
It's smart that they didn't implement it into public play, because that would have nerfed Russians too hard.
Oh! I love the Russians. I love the Russians. I love your Russia and Ukraine.
It was a Russian GGs.
Man, I love him. I love him so much. I love always going to Star Ladder. I don't want you to say anything bad about the Russians, man. sit. Capitalist, have a 2-week break and think about what you just
Listen,
did.
Listen, it was just, it was...
No,
Russian
no,
GGs
no,
are not,
that's
are,
it,
are not
that's
just
it.
Russians.
Capitalist is banned from the live stream for 2 weeks. He can't come back for 2 weeks because he insulted the Russians. He also won't be back for 2 weeks because he's off to do his military service. So have a great time, Cap. Have a great time. Thanks for joining me for the Bigpoint Battle.
Thanks for having me. Also, Toby.
Yeah?
Since I'm going to be gone...
Yeah.
Don't think I don't know. I know.
I just
want to wish you a happy birthday, man.
Shut up.
Yep, that's right. Threw it out on stream. Everybody.
Thanks
knows,
for watching,
man.
Everybody. We're going to wrap this one up. Don't go watch Capitalist live stream. Stay here for the rebroadcast instead. It's going to be long with a lot of breaks, but hey, we always have good tunes on this live stream. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you all tomorrow, 18 CEST, for the second day of the Bigpoint Battle. We'll see you then.